back with the pulse. So President Barack Obama has warned Syria that if it uses or moves its chemical or biological weapons, the U.S. might intervene. Obama told reporters at the White House that any action involving the weapons would constitute a red line.
We have been very clear to the Assad regime, but also to other players on the ground, that a red line for us is we start seeing a whole bunch of chemical weapons moving around or being utilized.
Well, away from Syria, security concerns in the region are very much focused on Iran and how Israel might respond to the Iranian nuclear program. Well, a new report says an Israeli military strike on the country on Iran could cost Israel's economy as much as $11 billion. Well, Eyal Yanai is chief executive officer of BDI, the Israeli business and credit information company, which authored that report. He joins us live now from Tel Aviv. And so could you start by telling us a little bit more about the scenario that this figure is based on and how you came to $11 billion as the cost to Israel's economy of any sort of military escalation between Iran and Israel?
Well, basically, it's a direct cost and indirect cost. And what we took as a model is the previous war in 2006, the Lebanese war, which actually cost Israel 0.5% of the GDP at that time, plus 1.3% in indirect cost. And direct cost would be, you know, housing that fall down and will be the actual prices of the war, equipment, oil, etc. An indirect cost is the cost to businesses which have to shut down. The last time, for 32 days, we had missiles attacks on Israel and some of the businesses had to shut down. The last time it was concentrated in the north of Israel, which encompasses about 20% of the GDP. This time, in our estimation, it could be affecting in a much wider area, maybe 70% of the country. Therefore, the cost will be higher.
And just thinking about, indirect, it's based on indirect and direct costs. Did you look at all at the potential upward spiral in oil prices?
Yes, absolutely. Although that will be an effect over a period of time and not the immediate effect. We took into consideration the fact that over a period of 5 years after the military action, the business failures in Israel could rise by about 10% more than the average business failure.
How high is the risk of any sort of military escalation between Iran and Israel? Because, of course, the rhetoric back and forth is nothing new. Yes, you have the Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu saying, well, time is running out for a peaceful solution. You have Iran coming out with a counter comment to that. What are the specific signs that investors should look for if and when this rhetoric is starting to become something a little bit more serious?
Well, basically, economic-wise, of course, I'm not talking politically, but economic-wise, it's at the moment, it's very much business as usual, because according to our survey, it doesn't look as though, even if there is a strike, it doesn't look as though it's going to be a catastrophe to the economy. And therefore, I think my advice to investors would be, at the moment, is business as usual. And only if something happens or something occurs, then we should look at it. But if you look at last few times, the stock exchange did not react.
Yes.
The economy was normal.
From what you're saying, it's not having any impact on the economy right now. But tell me, I know that these figures are based on the economic damage done to Israel from the war in Lebanon in 2006, but Iran is totally different to Lebanon. I mean, what is the risk that you are completely underestimating the cost of the damage to the Israeli economy?
Well, as I said, we took into consideration the fact that it's not 20% of the country and the economy and the GDP that will be influenced, but the wider area is like 70%. So we multiply the effect by at least three. Of course, it could be a completely different war, but I think this is a scenario which is quite realistic, in our opinion. Of course, it's not a catastrophic scenario.
Well, it's definitely a scenario that many investors have in the back of their minds, particularly if they're looking at the region itself. Good to talk to you, Eyal Yanai of BDI. Thank you for your time today.